Good afternoon, everybody. I'll just carry on from where the gentleman left. We also have in our midst a very special invitee, Mr. B.S. Jong, Executive Director, Marketing, Sales and Service, Hyundai Motor India. So I would kindly request Mr. Jong to please come on the stage and be with us. So Mr. Jong is an old India hand. It's his second stint in India with Hyundai. He has worked very closely with all of your dealers. Most of you recognize him well, have kind of taken advantage of his sales experience. And we are very happy to have him here as part of this panel. With that, I think it's over to you, Amit and Baliara, to start and take this.
Great panel. You can talk about, you know, how they can really take advantage. To start with, you know, Sagar, I would like to start since you're presenting on Google. What are your thoughts on digitalization, how adverts can be used by our dealers, how they can take advantage of the ecosystem you have really built?
Hello. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back after lunch. Everybody had a good lunch, I hope. And usually this is called a graveyard shift when people tend to doze off. So hope you'll do justice to your time here once again. And so yes, AdWords. So and I'll. Lot of people say, oh, it's very complex, very technical. There is bidding involved, etc., etc. I'll not go into that. I think I want to just say that AdWords is a Google tool to put your best message in front of the best customer at the most relevant time. And in a way that you can really control your costs. So aapka jo best customer kaun hai? I went to Auto Expo yesterday and there were thousands of people. It was a mad rush. Like, me and my son were there, you know, we were almost trampled, right? Because, but not everybody is a customer. So what we think of best customer is who has the intent. Jo kuch karne wale, mujhe kaari khareedna hai. And we've been talking about, there were presentations in the morning and we were talking about people go online. So people go in the Auto Expo, there is a new car. What do? They come back, they search. They say, okay, what is the price of this car? What is the expense? Specification, how does it compare to other cars, you know, what is the lifetime, you know, ownership cost of this car, maybe servicing mein kitna kharcha aayega and all that. So those are your best customers. And do you think ke wo jaake apne newspaper mein dekhenge ki achha iska ad aaya tha, main apna 22 March ko 2015 mein ad aaya tha, wo newspaper nikalu aur us ad mein dekhun ke kahan number hai dealer ka ya kahan main baat karu. So they're going to use ad, they're going to use Google search or any other search to actually figure out what it is. And that's where you can be present to answer those questions. So I think to sum up, I would say three things: reach, relevance, return on investment. You can reach a large number of audience. You can reach them at the most relevant time and in a manner that you can control your cost.
What I heard you say was how a relevant searcher has to be captured at the right time, and Google search is the most prominent search in India, and you can probably use that to capture the intent at that very moment when that person is looking for you or for dealers in your city. So we'll have to understand that, you know, this is like a digital marketing team that we need to be expertise by all the dealers. Now I would invite B.S. Jong on your thoughts on how digitalization is happening in Hyundai, and what are your thoughts, how do you see the future?
Good afternoon. My name is B.S. Jo. Actually, I was born in Korea, but in India, my experience is second time. I work in India from 2007 to 2011, and I came back to my hometown. This is my India. actually, I met some other manufacturer dealer owner here. I'm very happy to see other dealers owner also. Some of the Hyundai dealer owner, they know my the working style, my the mindset also. Anyway, the, my feeling is very, very comfortable in India. Many people, they are saying that India is not good country, blah, blah, like that. But I told them, personally, I like India. They have the many regions like India. I have many regions also. People who does not know India, the, actually, they are saying India is not good country, blah, blah. But I know India is very good country. I worked in Poland 1 year, and I worked in the Turkey 2 years. Compared to other countries, India is better country, correct. And India people also, good people. You are very emotional and very kind person, frankly, like Koreans. Also, the I worked in India almost, this time it is 6 years, right? But Korean people and Indian people are very similar. Korean people are very emotional, and Indian people are very emotional. But only one thing is different, only. Totally one thing is very, very different between Indian people and Korean people. And the Korean people, without drinking, they cannot dance. But Indian people, without drinking, you can dance very well. This was amazing people. We never think like this. Korean people never do that with dance without drink. This is Korean culture. But Indian people, you are dancing very well without drinking. Right? This is totally different. This is only one thing different. Other thing is very, very similar. Right? That's why Korean company and the Indian employee, we are working very well. Also, the US customer regarding the digital marketing. And our vice chairman also very young generation. And January last month, he visited in India. Because Indian market is a very important market. That's why he visited India in January. Within his agenda, he focused on the digital marketing. I'm also thinking digital marketing is very, very important for the future. That's why HMI also, we are studying how to develop digital marketing among our dealer side and the company side also. That's why we are studying how to develop digital marketing. And from the morning session, I've seen the customer leads through the digital marketing, right? But through my experience, customer leads is okay. It's important also. But most important thing is how to follow up. This is most important. And through the CarDekho, our dealer says you can need 500,000 leads, right? But how to follow up with the proper way? This is the most important, right? After receiving a lot of custom leads, if you cannot follow up with the right way, this is meaningless. That's why we should develop how to follow up these leads with the proper way, and on time, and with a nice way, nice manner to the customer. This is the most important. Anyway, I want to say to you, digital marketing is our future. But we should develop some system. How to exactly follow our personal needs. That is the most important. Thank you.
Completely agree. Thanks so much for telling so much about Korea and India. And when we drink and dance, we do nagin dance. Thank you so much for that, Mr. John. I would love to hear, Mr. Vikas, you know, on what you think about, you know, your heading sales, you know, a lot of pressure on numbers. I know numbers have been soaring up. How do you see digital contributing to that?
You see, it is very clear that that's the future. And one thing which, you know, we all are seeing a big change in the last 5 years in our country
is the young population, the young generation which is coming up, which is completely Android-based. They live their lives on their mobile. I have a son who is completing his engineering now. They don't read newspapers, they don't watch TV. But you ask them any question, they are aware of it. What they is of interest, they are tracking it. They are capable of doing multi-programming, processing at the same time. While we used to study, we used to switch off the music, close the room, no disturbance, nobody should ring the doorbell, otherwise I'll get disturbed. That's how I studied and got into engineering and MBA. But the young generation would be attending to phone calls, doing SMS, doing WhatsApp, still studying and doing well in the exams. It's a always online. So that's a big change. So we need to adapt ourselves. I think in this room we have huge experience. People more than 30 years of experience in automobile trade. How many of you would be more than 30 years? More than 20 years? More than 10 years? I think this country owes motorization to all of you. You have seen motorization. The large change which I see is the business is moving from an art of running an automobile business to science of running an automobile business. So to adopt digital, you need to be scientific. And as you become more scientific, we will start seeing the results. Results are still a long way to go in our country as far as digital goes. We're just starting the process. Case example, we are trying to show a model here, or a pack here, or an app here. We say, oh, internet speed is not there. But imagine millions of customers, and to cover your point, Mr. Saxena here, Pradeep Saxena is here, to cover his point as well. How many of them can download and see things at the speed they need to see things? These could be some of the things which need to be worked on, but yes, change is happening very fast. And all of us need to together adopt for the future customers. For them, it's all online, all digital. Nothing exists without digital. Don't expect the future customers to come and haggle for discounts. They would look at the net, look at the best deal, and press the button, this is what I want. And that's the largest change. So from the customer's point of view, things are changing. And from the employee's point of view as well, you need what we typically see in a casino, you know. You have people running the casino, but you have cameras all over. And in today, the modern casinos you go, you see they are being watched and observed for every deal. And the person who is on the table playing the cards for you, if he does a mistake, there's a call coming to him, oh, you made a mistake, refund the money to the customer. Have you experienced that? Yeah? Automobile dealers should have experienced these things. So the point is, what you actually say, the control of observing every interaction with the customers. How can I capture the facts easily through Android? How can I coach, develop, support, train my people? Is the second level of adaptation which is required, where I don't see digital only on one aspect of only getting a customer, but working with the customers on process front of it is also equally important to get this moving well.
Yep, I completely agree what Vikas says. What I observed is, it goes back to my same point, what you can measure, you can improve. And that is exactly what Mr. Jong and Vikas have mentioned, that if the sales follow process cannot be measured, you cannot improve it. You'll have to break it down into steps, smaller steps, measure each step, and identify where your guy needs training. The executive is working on your leads, you'll have to identify that. But if you can measure it, it's like a black box. You don't know what's not working for you. Great thoughts, Mr. Vikas. Love hearing them. Mr. Chandrasekhar, what are your thoughts on digital marketing?
As a dealer, my thoughts are this. See, I think under when Mr. Vikas Jain was in GM, for about 4 years, he was driving digital marketing and digital, he was bringing in the change in GM. GM is one of the first few companies who has brought in digital marketing or digital culture to India. And I think one of the year I was awarded the best dealer in digital conversion. So we took it up very fast, and I strongly I mean, as I said earlier, and I'm again reiterating, I think this is the only way. It's rather than saying digitalization is the future, I would say this is the only way. If you need to survive, I think there's no other way. You've got to go digital.
Thank you. Great to see, you know, somebody from Dealer Fraternity representing this panel and talking about what digitalization has been able to help. Nalan, you're the unique one, you know, who has seen 6 months of CarDekho, and all your life you have seen, you know, auto. And would love to hear your thoughts. I learned a lot from you in the last 6 months, frankly. I would love to hear your perspective because you've seen both the worlds so closely.
Thanks, Amit. Thank you, gentlemen, everybody here. So as you said, digitalization is not the future. I mean, is the future, somebody say. I say it is the present now. Of course, it's already there, and we just have to perceive it. So Amit, I'll flip this over your question. So you represent CarDekho, and you are from Google, and they are from OEMs. I'll represent the dealers today, okay? So many of the dealers I've spoken to when I speak about digital solutions have this apprehension, okay? And correct me if I'm wrong. Many of you have this apprehension that if they go more into digital, okay, if they depend on more what Vidya does in terms of SEOs and SEMs, they are losing control over their own consumer. Okay? Many of the dealers have told me that. The point is that true? I personally feel that the more you digitalize, the more you make your processes transparent, it actually builds up a lot of value into your system, and you gain far superior control of your businesses and your consumers than you do today. Right, Amit, would you like to say something on that?
Look, I'll put it this way. I can't sell cars, as I said before. Also. I think it's a partnership. We can coexist. I can't exist alone as CarDekho, very frankly. The business model won't survive. I'm not an expert at, you know, running a car dealership, and somebody here in the crowd was, you know, while I was just sitting, said that why don't you open a dealership? I said, no, I'll never open a dealership. That's not the core forte of mine. My core forte is technology. And I have gone to bridge the gap between dealership business and the consumer, and trying to make consumer life seamless. I think we'll work as partners, Nalan. I do not foresee that we'll be competing. World over, it has not happened anywhere that auto will be competing. Digitalization has only helped dealers make road processes more transparent, more measurable, and that's how I look upon, you know, how things have transformed abroad also. I've been to China, I've been to the US, I've noticed the same thing, and I can already see some top dealers in India already following this, and they have better conversion, they have better sales. So I would frankly recommend that instead of shying away, give it a shot. If it works, great. If it does not work, then probably, you know, people like us will have to work harder.
So the message from Amit is very clear: embrace the change, embrace the digital. Vidya Sagar, could you substantiate, or what are your thoughts on what Amit just mentioned?
Yeah, hello. So I just wanted to jump in. Thanks for calling me out. So essentially, future is here, future is now. And if you look back, when printing press was invented, you know, I'm not sure when it was, a couple of hundred years ago, the knowledge which was in the heads of people was written and transmitted or distributed at scale. Like newspaper happened, books happened. So this democratization of information happened. Internet is another similar change, and we are living through it today. Now this information access that a PhD scholar in Stanford has, the same information is available to me, to a farmer in Uttarakhand or wherever. So this change is happening all around us. I think the point I'm trying to make is that we have to really embrace this change. It is no longer a choice. We cannot say that if I do digital, I lose control of my customers. It is the customers or the consumers who are deciding what they're going to use and how they're going to use it. If you look at the, you know, Ubers of the world, or Amazons of the world, or e-commerce, there is personalization. Like every user, their marketing message is different to every user. And you can do that today with the help of technology. And I think similarly, we have to actually respond to what is happening outside of us, what is happening in the ecosystem, what are consumers doing. And consumers are living on the internet, and there is a term which we call micro moments. There was an India Day, Google for India, in December. Entire Google leadership was here, and just to showcase Google's commitment to India. And we did a research and published that study there. That there was a between May 2014 and May 2015, the number of online sessions using smartphones actually saw a 30% jump. However, the duration of those online sessions actually went down by about 28%. So now the world has changed. It's not that Indian internet user had to go to a cyber cafe, buy for 1 hour internet, and then, okay, I have to do whatever I have to do. He has this internet all the time with them. And they go out, reach out to this internet when they need it. Everybody is almost carrying a supercomputer in their pockets. India has just become second largest smartphone market in the world. 220 million smartphone users just recently. Yeah, it's a few days ago. So I think I would say it's no longer a choice. I think consumers are already there. It's up to us. How do we actually make the most of this opportunity? And again, going back to my point, this opportunity is maybe much more disruptive or much more big than what happened with the printing press and so on.
Sure. Thanks very much. So the key points which emerges, one is embrace the change. I would add the word positive, you know. This change is leading to something positive. The second part which I catch from you, and Amit also mentioned in his presentation in the morning, let's take the case of dealer website. So what you are saying is, consumer is shopping 24/7. He is not coming to the dealership every point of time, but who knows, in the midnight, he is trying to locate you through your website to know what you do and what you can do for him. That's the kind of retail. I'll probably narrate a very short story, and then I'll come to Mr. Jong and Mr. Jain, and all the OEMs who can relate to me. Since Han is sitting right in the corner, I met Mr. Eric was. So just a very short story. Or people who have worked in automotive industry, because please correct me if I'm wrong, whatever I say, just hold me back to it. They're having some typical problems among dealerships. That's what OEMs always talk about. In car industry, what is your test drive ratio? Okay. That's what OEM, RM, ZM would always talk to you. What is your test drive ratio? Okay. Second is, are you following up on your leads? Are you following up on your inquiries? Third, what is your conversion ratio? What is your conversion ratio on walk-ins? These are the same questions, same kind of monitoring, which has been happening since the time I started my career, which was long back, 15 years back, test drive ratio improvement. I used to work for a company, and 15 years back, there was a big project which came from global headquarters. Your test drive ratio is only 30%, make it 100%. Because theoretically, every company believes you have to give a test drive to each and every guy. Last 15 years, 4 MDs have changed in that company. 3 executive directors have changed. Everything has changed. But the ratio is still the same. Right? Am I? Absolutely. All of us. Mr. Jong, you agree? Something like that. Minor improvement. So these are some of the inherent challenges and problems among automotive dealership. It's the first time I'm answering Amit's question when you ask me, what have I observed coming to this side? I have observed real solutions. Solutions which can change these long-standing issues, which we have been trying to address manually with little or no success. Agree with me? And some of the solutions which Amit presented today, LMS app, I don't want to go into the details, but phenomenal things. So I'm not here to sell CarDekho. These are digital solutions, okay? But the point is, digital works. So coming back to Mr. Vikas Jain, what do you feel of some long-standing problems and how technology can solve them? Are you thinking of them?
Yeah, so I'll go back to the stage when, you know, motorization started in this country. Imagine we were selling how many cars across the year?
3 lakh cars, 2.5 lakh, 3 lakh cars, limited scope for the customers.
We move to 3 million.
We need to move to 4 million, 4.5 million, 5 million. Good news is Indian economy is, you know, the GDP has taken over China, first time in the history. Shows a lot of positivity. But if I talk as a professional, if I look at the number of two-wheelers sold, gives me a clear example of how much this industry holds the potential. Now to handle large base of customers and maintain the test drive ratios or the conversion ratio, we need technology. We need to adopt things which takes care of a customer need as per his convenience, his timelines, and his requirement. An engineer may come to buy a car, his expectation may be drastically different from a trader coming from a market, or a doctor who's got no time, all the time is in the hospital. Today we don't have solutions possibly effectively in this on the roles, but if you adopt technology, you can start dreaming, you can start thinking about all such possible solutions. So I completely agree with Nalin in terms of technology and the digital typically on all perspective does seem to be promising for solutions.
Thank you. Mr. Jong, you have worked around the world as you mentioned, right? And of course in Korea, which is a very advanced. When I used to go to Korea, the speed at which internet connects, you know, is anybody's business. Awesome. I don't know how many Mbps or Gbps, okay, with this hardware would know that. So, Mr. Jong, looking at the international perspective, how things are changing and what are the key focus areas to move into the digital world? What are the key issues, key problems, key areas in which digital can make a big difference?
Anyway, the Korea, the internet speed is very fast, very, very fast. Because the Korea land size is very small, right? That's why very fast. But India, your land size is very big land size. That's why your internet speed is like slow, right? But Korea is a very small country. That's why our internet speed is very fast. Anyway, you can develop, right? This is no issue. For the future, step by step, you can develop. But I want to say to one thing. My automobile experience, 27 years this year. Through my experience, I want to say to you, Azure, you are the businessman, right? Hyundai dealer owner, and Maruti, Tata, GM, Honda dealer owner. And okay, system, technology, it's important. It's important, right? But let's see. Who will follow up? Who will check? I want to say to you, most important issue is people. Right? Your the quality manpower is very, very important. Okay, you develop very good system, internet, technology, right? But who will handle it? Who will check? Who will follow up? That's why I want to suggest to you, as a dealer owner or as a businessman, please focus on your quality manpower to develop this one. Otherwise, even the good system, good technology, you cannot utilize this one. And then, meaningless. That's why it's very, very important. Okay, making the digital technology. After that, who will handle it? Who? That's why each the people who are working with you is very, very important with the quality. But it's not easy, right? That's why train them, follow up, how to improve their quality. It's very, very important, very, very. That's why I want to say to you, everything is becoming from the quality manpower. Otherwise, it's not implemented. That's why I say to our company employee, out of your job, 60-70% following up, checking. Most important thing. Okay, you've done test drive with the proper way or not. Okay, you are the salesman, we'll say to you, So I conducted a test drive. But nobody knows how. You've done test drive with the customer with a nice way or not. And then, okay, they are reporting to you, so I finished the test drive. But how? Your test drive customer was satisfied or not? Nobody checking this one. And then your test drive ratio is increasing, 60%, 70%, 80%. But your CAC is not increasing. And then, who will know this one? Why test drive ratio is increasing? The why the our the CAC is going down? That's why. So dedicated and the quality manpower should check this one. And then you know what is the main reason. Otherwise, you cannot know. That's why I want to suggest fully focus on to improve your quality, dedicated manpower. And then you'll make success.
Thank you, Mr. So, very clearly, improving the quality at the dealership so that the customer follow-up happens and the customer engagement happens very clearly. Welcome, Mr. Sumit Chani. So, Amit, I'll come back to you with a very difficult one, but before that, a quick one to translate. What Mr. Jong mentioned about inquiry, follow-up, and these things, these are hygiene for a dealership. A dealership exists to sell and to get back to consumer. But why does it happen that there are always problems in this? And the second part is, can digital and how can digital play a role in this?
Okay, I'm sorry. I want to ask the old dealer owner. You are the inquiry enough or not? I want to ask to you, all dealers, customer inquiry is enough or not? Is it enough? It's enough or not?
Are your customer inquiries enough or not? That's what Mr. Jung wants to know.
No.
Say yes, say no, whatever you want to.
Everyone wants to sell more.
Vidyasagar is very happy looking, hearing that.
You know, I was saying that, of course, there's a case for more inquiries and being there when customers are actually looking for.
But, okay, before increasing your the inquiry, customer leads through the digital marketing, you should be prepared. You're the inner manpower, quality manpower. After receiving the customer leads from the CarDekho digital marketing, okay, who will follow up? How to follow up? First, should be prepared in your organization. After that, you can consider. Without this kind of organization, without this kind of the manpower, okay, CarDekho digital marketing, you are receiving a lot of inquiry. But after that, nobody follow up. And then this is meaningless. Before that, should prepare your organization, your manpower, your department, how to follow up, how to second follow up also, right? This kind of thing.
Thank you. Yes, Chandrasekhar.
I think there are many parameters which lead from an inquiry to a conversion, and process excellence, according to me, is a very, very key parameter in achieving conversion. Apart from manpower, quality manpower, training, and the energy and aura in the dealership, which are very key parameters which lead from an inquiry to a conversion. And you asked me a very good question on how can digitalization help in this particular process. And that's where I think, you know, number of inquiries, you can play a very key role, which you're already playing. And process excellence. I've seen your app, which is a very, very beautiful app on how a sales executive, using his mobile phone, can track the leads, can track on the, I mean, every day when he comes back to the dealership. Of course, there is a process which is laid down by the principals. But I think what you have integrated from the DMS to the app plays a very key role, and I feel that that's going to be a differentiating factor, and that can play a very huge role.
Thank you. So, Amit, I said I'll come with a very difficult one. So, you showed us a lot of technology, and many digital guys from digital and technical field show us. As I said, I'm representing the dealers today, so don't. So a lot many technologies are showcased, are explained in various fora, and today also. Is it real? Is the technology available? Can it be adopted? Can it be kind of used today by your dealers to help them into some of the things we just described? We need to know your viewpoint. And I would also like to then probably spend a few moments on what Chandrasekhar said about how the inquiry follow-up to the sale and all that bit, what are the solutions on that, which you briefly touched upon in the morning, and how do they actually work?
The technologies that we have built are available, but I would not recommend to adopt right away. And I'm as CarDekho CEO telling you not to take them until you are prepared. And Mr. Jong rightly said, you'll have to first prepare your base. Technology cannot sell cars, people sell cars. Technology allows people to be more efficient. If you're not willing to have trained manpower, which is trained to use the technology, technology will not work for you. So the first thing I want to say clearly is digital does not work until the people are trained to use the technology, follow the process. Number two, and most importantly, if you as dealer principals are not seeing the numbers every day, it will never work. Because what you can measure is what you can improve. So if you're not measuring all the various steps of consumer experience, you'll not be able to improve it. Technology can only give you numbers out and you can measure how am I doing. But that does not tell you how does a guy perform better. Unless you're following up with your own people, it won't happen ever. My answer, Nalin, to your question is that it won't happen until all the dealerships adopt the technology. Since Nalin is not around, I will open this to Sagar on your thoughts on. So you are basically a lead generation engine, thank you. How can Google be of more help than just lead gen? Or how can Google help catch target consumers? Nalin, since you were not there, I had to pass on another question.
Please, yeah.
Sure, I think, I'll echo the sentiment. Technology in itself cannot solve problems. You have to have the people. And just briefly, I'll touch one point. Right? So we have a premium partnership with CarDekho. And the only reason is that Google does not have people in all the cities where you are, but they have. We have the technology and we say, okay, let's partner. And of course, when we partner, we really want to look at that, yes, we will be very comfortable sitting with them in a forum like this. So people are important, just to add. Now, coming back to what other pieces of technology, and I'll just pick up Mr. Jong's point that, okay, what is the quality of test drive? And I saw a very innovative solution by somebody in Australia. It is a Toyota dealership. They put a dashboard camera, all right? And every phone has a camera. You just put by a small hanger where you stick the camera in, front camera, and then they record the entire test drive experience. What question the consumer was asking, how was he feeling? When the new feature was introduced, there was a delight. And after the test drive, what they do is they just create a small video out of that experience, and just send it to the customer as a post test drive engagement measure. And it is not like rocket science. It is not it's again people. So the people who are there, he has to be trained, he should be motivated enough to start the camera, actually take that and actually have that conversation, which will look good on camera, of course. So similarly, there you saw Rajan's presentation. There was this Fiat dealership, I think, which had this live showroom piece, or there was an Audi live cam. You know, all those things. Of course, they are much more sophisticated. You have a live, specially designed camera, and so on and so forth. But I think today there is freely available technology. I would say Google Hangouts, where you can actually do a live hangout with the customer. If a rep is at a customer's place, they can actually do a video call. Today, network speeds, at least in the metro cities, are happening. 4G is on the horizon. I think it will happen in other parts. So I think there is a ton of technology available today, which is free, and only the innovative use. I mean, little bit of innovation, good people, good training, good processes, and I think you can really differentiate yourself as a dealership which is catering to the next generation and make the most of the change that is happening around us.
Thank you. Coming back to this side now. So you know when an ad is designed to be published in a newspaper, it goes through so many layers of review within the company, maybe 4 or 5 layers down, up to the MD. Everybody checks what is the color, this circle doesn't look round enough, this letter A is not so nice, everything changes, right? So a lot of effort goes into it. Everybody wants to do a perfect job. Okay, so the question is coming to you. First, all the dealers raise their hands. One hand only. Okay. Hands down, please. If an ad is released by the manufacturer in your territory, a big ad, or by you dealers as a joint publicity with the regional office, can any dealer out here say with confidence that 100% of the calls which come to your dealership after spending lakhs, 100% of the calls are picked up by your staff and spoken to and worked upon properly? Which dealer says 100% of his calls are picked up? Who's confident? Raise a hand. You're right, all of you are honest guys. Nobody has that confidence. Glad, you're all very honest guys. Don't you think each and every call needs to be picked up? Because it's your money which is going into it. Now, recently we have started working, or digital industry has started working, let me not say we, digital industry has started working with various OEMs and dealers like you on tech solutions, for which there was no solution for last decades. There was no means of knowing the amount of money which we are spending is leading to what. So there's a tech solution which tells you from a particular ad on that day in that newspaper how many calls came to your dealership, at what time, how many of them were picked up, how many of them were just neglected, and from the number of calls which were picked up, what was the duration of each call, and to top it off, each and every call can be recorded and heard by the dealer principal as an audit mechanism. Now, is it a wonderful solution? Definitely it is. Sorry? Yes. Exactly what B.S. John was mentioning. There's so much effort everybody puts in to get people, to get inquiries, but what happens to the after that, nobody knows. And Anand Wadhwa is nodding his head. I know you run various dealerships in various locations. How would you control this at all locations sitting at one place? You can't do it manually. This is where technology comes into play. And Amit, how does it work? Does technology help in this? And after that, we'll jump to Vikas and know his viewpoint on some of the pending issues and how dealers should work and apply technology.
So I think we've spoken a lot of tech. How many of you use AdWords, Google AdWords? Raise your hands. Exactly. Sagar keeps on asking me, Amit, you are present in so many cities. Why my AdWords don't sell? I told him that, you know, until dealers have website, AdWords don't work. Let me first work on digitalization of India where we can do that. So technology has to go a long way. I think there are basic solutions that need to be adopted first. It will be a step-by-step process, Nalin, in my opinion. It won't be like you come up with great tech, it will get adopted. India will take time to adopt, sure. And everybody needs to get trained. I think we should be patient. We should invest a lot more on training than what we do. As dealers also, and as CarDekho, as a company also, everybody will have to spend a lot of money, invest a lot of money in people training. Then only technology solutions work. Exactly to my last point, do not invest in digital until you are ready. You'll waste your money. And then you'll curse digital doesn't work. I do not want to hear that. I know digital works, but if it is done in a process.
Thank you, Amit. Vikas, we'll come to you. And after that, probably we'll go to the house and take some questions or some observation. But Vikas, your point on some of the issues and some of the latest trends which you feel can imbibe and adopt this technology very fast and how it helps the dealer business. So between you and me,
dealer profitability is a big issue. It's a secret talk between you and me. Everybody says there's a profitability. How does all this tie up to the basis of business, which is profitability?
Thanks, Alan. So, you know, in my 2.5 decades of experience where we have seen things changing, what would help all of us would to understand things are changing, but they're not only changing, they're changing at a phenomenal speed. The first slide which, you know, we saw from the Google presentation, number of adopters, 1 billion in just 8 years. It's going to shorten to further 5 years, 3 years. So we have to change. Technology is available, tools are available. We need to adopt them, use them, see, change, and further improve on them. Now, what's holding on in adopting that? I think that's one thing which I would like to highlight with my experience of handling almost 500 or 600 dealerships in the entire country and very close interaction. The issues will remain till we develop the roadmap for adopting technology, which will start with we discussing on future. I don't know how many of us really discuss about future. How is our customer? How is our employer? What's the technology? Same is like profitability. When I talk to dealer principals in different forums, I ask, how many hours you spend on profitability? Once in a month, 2 hours, or maybe 6 monthly when you're doing some trial balances or provisional balance sheets, you end up seeing figures and deciding this is not working or this is working. That needs to be changed. We need to start measuring everything to the brass or to the granular level. Now, to be able to measure to the granular level, you need technology, you need digitalization, you need to use every employee to record data. If you look at what Google is talking or what CarDekho is talking or what, you know, Google world of ads are talking or anything you talk, it's nothing but analytics. If you are aware of analytics, very well. If you're not, please start talking and understanding and discussing this one word, analytics, and you will discover a different world altogether that what is controlling the consumer behavior. The retail world is completely controlled by analytics. And it's amazing how it works. So your individual dealer principal's knowledge and then the dedication or the commitment to adopt things by making a roadmap for future is something which will help. What holds you back, in my experience, to work on profitability or work on digitalization is the same reason. The reason is, I got my target of doing 1,000 cars in a month. I'm a big group having 22 branches. I'm doing my 1,000 cars, company is happy, I'm getting my award. I don't need to worry. I will continue doing what I'm doing. I'm happy. That's one single reason that what has worked for you for last 3 years, 5 years, you have found that magic formula, you want to continue driving that. But that may not work sometime later. So the idea is change with your environment changing around this.
So thanks, Mr. Vikas. I think we need to wrap up this session. And we have time for about 2-3 questions. Anybody? Quick questions, please.
Yeah. Hi. In continuation to what all of you said, I think we need to adapt ourselves for the next 5 to 10 years, actually. So when you talk about technology, it's not just today. I need to plan what is going to come probably 2 years down the line, 5 years down the line. Unfortunately, every solution offered in the market, not just by CarDekho, but by everyone, is actually only entertaining a part of the business. You are talking about lead generation, somebody is talking about services revenue, somebody is talking about insurance business. Also, it is coupled by the fact that manufacturers themselves are working on something else. Now, I as a dealer, how do I plan when I don't know what is the right DMS for me? I don't know if I take a solution from you for inquiry management, but I don't have stock on it. I don't have, let's say, my accounting on it. How do I really plan for the future?
I think you have a very valid question.
And that's where collaborative working is required between the OEs, the car portal companies, and the dealerships. If we have anyone missing out of it, it will not work.
I completely buy that. It will have to be us working together. And we have a similar agenda to drive, frankly. Why am I building this technology? So that the leads I give you, in fact, I don't even charge for this technology, right? The reason I give it is at least the leads that I give you will be monetized. And if you don't sell any car, you would never buy my leads, right? And I want to work with manufacturers directly to provide a seamless integration between this technology so you don't have to update leads twice, right? It becomes a nightmare. I completely buy that.
But you know, the problem is, as a dealership, how do I plan? Because I start using your system today, any system as a matter of fact, but after a year, probably there's somebody better or somebody different, and a manufacturer is coming out with another type. Maybe I'm working with you, but somebody's working with someone else.
You know, this is their area of expertise, but I will answer you. Have you got a chance to interact with software professionals who are working on different projects at a senior level? The biggest challenge they have is that things are changing every 3 months, every 6 months. So the competency which will drive businesses across the globe would be adaptability, would be flexibility. Let's become as adaptable and as flexible. Don't think of a solution which will continue you for 5 years. We will be extremely wrong when we do that. That's what I am saying. You know, the change is happening very fast, and we have to also adapt how to change very fast. And that would be the answer. I don't know if I have answered it.
Yeah, I think I would have answered similar. And to add to it, I think everybody sitting in this room, yeah.
No, no, Anand never does anything without manufacturer's consent. I can bet on that.
Look, frankly, I'll put a final comment to this question. We in this room will not be able to decide what technology will be used at least time. The most usable product that executive likes will be is what will be used. आप लोगों ने EMI calculator executive को नहीं दिया manufacturer ने तो उसने खुद ने download कर लिया ना Android app से use कर रहा है जहाँ पर उसका incentive बनता है आराम से उसका धंधा चलता है he'll use that in my opinion. So products have to be usable and that's what we are trying to focus on making products more usable. I think none of us in the room will be able to decide you know which technology will be used. If we work together I think we'll be able to bring about a phenomenal technology together, manufacturers and auto portals, because we don't know how to manufacture cars. And likewise, know what I mean?
Sure, thank you. So we've got a bonus of time, a few more moments, and we'll go back to two questions. Yes.
Can I?
Okay, you have the mic as well as your hand, so you can get up. Yes. Yes, the gentleman in the front.
Okay. Yeah, good afternoon.
Yeah.
I'd like to speak about digital marketing. One of our expectations when we came and registered for this seminar was that we are going to hear about digital marketing. Yes, amazing app which you have designed, and your presentation with Amit was really great. In fact, we were sucked into the session and we really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
What we are missing as dealers, the pain point today, is qualified, trained marketing managers. How do we arrive at a digital marketing plan? We all have, what do you call, a regular marketing plan. So where do I spend the money? How do I spend the money? How do we use the Google Analytics? That's a great tool which is available, it's seldom being used by anyone. We thought we would find some solutions out over here. I would be going back as of now, I don't know what's lined up for the next session, which is on profitability. I feel that has not been touched.
Sure, I think it's a very valid point which you made. So let me share with you, not only dealers, but I've seen OEMs also and their marketing departments also struggle with getting good people who understand digital marketing. Not only OEMs, advertising agencies, including media agencies who are planning digital media, this expertise is not yet at a robust level there. So your challenge remains to be the challenge for everybody else. And I think as the ecosystem develops, some of it would be taken care of. But Amit, what is your point on that?
That's why CarDekho exists. Look, as dealerships, you can't afford to have a digital marketing guy on every single dealership. It won't be cost effective. And that's the reason why we partnered with Google. You don't have to run your ad, but we run it. You don't have to run your website, we'll run it. We know our technology best. We have got huge teams. We are a 2,800 people company, of which 1,000 people are developers, you know, developing technology day in and day out. you don't need to worry about all this, because you know, if you try to do it on your own, you can try it. I'm not arguing that you can't do it, but that would not be cost effective at all, because when I develop it and, you know, do it for all the dealers, it becomes really cost effective. I could claim a solution, you know, being as cheap, you know, when I presented last time, because I know that this solution will be used by multiple dealers. I don't have to overload one dealer with the cost. If you're developing your own technology as a dealer, I would completely recommend you seeing what solutions exist, frankly speaking. And you don't need to run your Facebook, you don't need to run your AdWords. We are there to help you. That's why we want to partner with you and help you out with all the digital marketing needs. And that's where we are expert at. We don't know how to sell cars. We don't know how to do digital marketing.
Okay, so I think just to substantiate, yes, after you.
So just to add to that, of course, manpower is a challenge, and we as Google also face this. And another angle to think about is that a person who is really smart, who is super sharp, who knows analytics, who knows digital marketing, is not going to come and work for a dealership managing, because his career options in future are limited. He's going to go work for a Google or a Facebook or a large media house and so on and so forth. So I think we have to really think about what we want to do ourselves and what we want to outsource. And you have to look for specialist companies who really know this space. For example, here we are, I'm talking about CarDekho. There are others in the market as well. CarDekho has a deep expertise in auto space. We bring in expertise around digital and we train their people. And I think it's a win-win for everybody.
Just so I think what you said is, instead of buying technology, instead of getting technology, look for a technology partner. And I think that also answers, Anand, what you said. The obsolescence is so high that if you focus only on technology today, probably it will get obsolete. But if you have a technology partner, probably it can help you through. Yes, we have another one.
Just a small suggestion or request.
Okay, please.
Might be FADA can partner with Google or CarDekho and come up with a one-day program where there are a lot of marketing jargon which is used, like SEO, SMM, CPC.
Vinkesh, you would like to respond?
So how do we, how do we kind of, how do our business heads learn all that so that they can understand all these things, even when you come on a consulting session to us?
I'm sorry to come in between the such a big speakers. We had already done this. We did a one-day session at Google not headquarters, but their office at Gurgaon. And the emails were sent to all the FADA members. I'm sorry if you haven't received it. We do it normally once a year. If you are interested, do send a mail and we do it again. That's a one-day session, and they give you all that
this photo.
Details of the jargon. So, and obviously, their purpose is you should tie up with them. FADA can't tie up with them. We have worked with them to come out with a solution, which obviously CarDekho is doing the same thing. And they have suggested us to tie up with CarDekho for all the future Google things. But they agreed to give you the direct training, the direct knowledge also.
I, along with Sagar, commit to you that we'll hold such session. We'll send out invites. Would love to have a participation. Would love to educate you more on what is SEO, what is SEM. Because I didn't feel that, you know, going to that depth would be absorbed by everyone. Because right now, many people would not even know the term SMO, SEM, SEO. I just want to touch the tip of the iceberg and, you know, then go deeper. And I agree that this has not been covered in depth, which will be covered in individual sessions which we'll hold with Google.
Absolutely. Mr. Rao and I spoke this afternoon. Delhi session was really liked by FADA members, and we said we need to quickly do one in Hyderabad. And again, we're going to plan a series of them in different cities.
Thank you. Okay, the third question, Amit, you can take over drinks, okay? We don't have time for that. So somebody has to ask a third question. We'll keep it for later. As I said, over dinner. Okay. We're running short of time.
We're running late on agenda. We'll just wrap it now because
we'll have to wrap it. So anybody has a point to wrap up, or we can just kind of.
So I just wanted to sum it up. I would say your consumer is already online. You have to be there. You have to be really useful to them, right? Answer the questions that they're asking. You have to be quick. Today is an instant gratification generation. They're not gonna wait for your website to load and, you know, they'll move on. So your websites, whatever assets you have online, has to be very, very responsive. And Amit Singhal, our head of search, who just moved on, his mantra was, we have three strategies, and they are mobile, mobile, and mobile. So for India, 65% of our users are mobile only. So your website, open your websites on mobile and see if that's working. It has to be really, really work on mobile. And the last point is connect the dots. Everybody was talking about measurement. talking about a number of calls which are not getting answers. And I can tell you that it's not true for only automotive. I work for a lot of SMEs as a partner manager with Google. And we see across SMEs, 70% of calls are either not answered or not answered in a manner which is effective. So I think consumers are there, but you have to really make sure that their experience is good and leverage the technology that is available.
Thank you.